Thank you. This was the end of the Stone Eaters. Thanks to Esselmir, the realm of Lothriel was safe. The spell had been broken once and for all.
This is a really great story.
What happened to Esselmir at that point? How did he spend the rest of his time the gods granted to him?
He never revealed to Halfuri that he was his real father. But when Perdurall died, he adopted the child. Together, they took a journey to Theosinbin, where Esselmir met the nice and sweet Dedadane. She left her life as a courtesan to stay at the side of the man who came from the mountains, to whom she felt connected by a deep affection. They spent several peaceful years together. When it was time to leave the living world, Esselmir was standing alone on the Dolphin Pier. He was contemplating the boundless horizon of the sea, thinking back to the events that had marked his adventurous existence. His goddess spoke to him one last time, telling him that although it was now time to leave his body, his soul would stay. It would continue to linger around this world, as a ghost, until the day in which he could finally tell his story to a young scribe, called Nalfordan Dominir.
So, you are...
Yes, the spirit of Esselmir. And I gift you my story, young Dominir. My story and my magic arrow, which was given to me by King Osindel. The fire arrow, because it belongs to your destiny.
I don't think I'm worthy of it. I'm not a warrior. I'm not a great hero. My life is on this chair. Why should I keep a magic arrow forged by the god of fire?
There's no way of knowing that, dear Dominir. The will of the heavens is inscrutable.
So, is this a farewell, O great Esselmir? You can't imagine the honor you've given us, making us witnesses and keepers of your story. Also, let me tell you how I and all my people are grateful to you for saving the realm of Lothriel from destruction. Without you, none of what happened afterward would ever have occurred. Sure, the world would have been spared of major disasters, but also its biggest joy. Only now we know. Now that the glorious and terrible events of the Seventh Age are being made.
It's not a farewell, Sir Helowin. Because today, I'm finally going back to the Heavenly Father Inkahal, to whom all of us belong, and where we will all meet again.
Child.